distance, or à loin in French, is a book I feel with at least two different layers. It's an adventure book, but it's also a very introspective book. The story is more or less this. There is this young boy who grows up in Sweden, very poor, illiterate. He doesn't know how to read or write. Obviously, he has no money. They're starving, quite literally starving. And their parents, his parents, send him and his brother to New York. This is the only word they know in English. They have never even seen a city. Partly because of this, changing ships in Portsmouth in England, they get separated. And the youngest boy, the protagonist of the book, ends up in San Francisco instead of in New York. So he decides to walk across the entire continent from the Pacific coast to the Atlantic coast in search of his brother, because on the other hand, the only word he knows in English is New York. So that works as a sort of talisman for him, a sort of a magnet that draws him east. The book takes place in the 1850s, which is the year of the gold rush, when gold was found in California and people are flocking to California to get rich fast. It is also the years of the Manifest Destiny, where the United States programmatically starts conquering what was considered the Wild West, with a great disregard for everyone who lived there, from the Native Americans to the fauna and the flora. Everything was destroyed in the path. So it's this enormous historical wave of prospectors, gold diggers, pioneers, and so on and so forth, going west, and we have this lonely man going in the opposite direction, going east. So he's going against the grain of history. And this was a good premise or a good excuse to try to explore this historical period from a different point of view. Another thing that the novel explores is the genre of the Western, which is a bizarre genre for me. I don't particularly like Westerns, but I found it a very interesting genre because it is a perfect ideological narrative for the history of the United States. It glamorizes and aestheticizes all the worst parts of our history: genocide, racism, the gun fetish, the obsession with private property, the individual above the law and the state, you know, the vigilante. For all of these reasons, and all of this becomes kind of very sexy and appealing in Western narratives, so it should have been the American genre, but for some reason, it really didn't take off. It has a very marginal place in the canon. So I thought that maybe hacking into this genre, squatting into or occupying this genre, was a good way to subvert all of these cliches and retell this portion of American history, and at the same time examining a portion of the American literary canon. I worked with very strict rules writing the book. One of them was the character is on this journey and he can never go back. He can never return to whatever place he has left. This resulted in a very episodic structure because he can't return ever. And each one of these episodes is a tableau or a vignette that is a very stereotypical cliché Western scene. The saloon, the gold mine, the caravan, and so on and so forth. But in each of these cases, the protagonists and the expectations are subverted. For example, very quick example, in the saloon, instead of having sort of a femme fatale or a prostitute, which is the commonplace, the woman is actually runs the saloon and she's in charge of this complex criminal gang and turns the protagonist into her sexual slave. So the roles are completely reverted. this is the adventure side of the book, but the book is also, I would say, first and foremost, it's an exploration of solitude. The character is completely alone for, I would say, good 80% of the book. He doesn't speak with anyone. He doesn't know English when he gets to America, so he doesn't understand what is being said to him, and neither does the reader. So he's completely lost geographically, linguistically, and also in time. He doesn't know how much time goes by. A few decades go by along the book, but he has no idea, neither does the reader. So it was an attempt at exploring this profound loneliness and this profound sense of foreignness, of being a complete foreigner in every possible way. And he's even a foreigner to the extent that he's in a country that doesn't really exist as such, because he is in what at the time was called the unorganized territories. So he's not even in the United States. So the book conjugates all these different elements. I think it's a fast-paced book on the one hand, but it's also a dense and viscous and interior book on the other hand.